just came on here today to say the message is still the same, guys. It's repentance. You know, it seems like somehow like repentance have a negative connotation to it, but the real truth is, sorry guys, it's not negative at all. The truth is, when God tells you to repent, God is trying to rescue you. It's not condemnation, at least not condemnation yet. If you don't repent, you will be condemned. But yeah, repentance is the message. And it's not really, you know, it's for some reason it seems like it's so taboo and people don't want to talk about that. But the reality is, if you're wrong, you're wrong. If you're living in sin, you're living in sin. And you got to tell God you're sorry. You got to tell God you're sorry. And that's what repentance is, you know, telling God you're sorry and asking for forgiveness and changing. You know, repentance is not just, you know, saying I'm sorry and then going back to doing the same thing. No, it's saying I'm sorry and, you know, believing God to change your heart by reading your Bible and praying and, you know, asking Him to fill you with His Spirit, and the transformation will take place. But guys, there's so much going on. These are the beginning of sorrows, whether you want to believe it or not. These are the beginning of sorrows. When it comes to the jab, I would say prayerfully consider your decision. I know you're used to living your life and making your decisions and doing whatever you want to do, but this is not, I repeat, this is not the season for that. It was never a season for that, but so much more so, it's not a season for that. Be prayerful about your decisions. Be prayerful about who's around you. Be prayerful about what you're doing. Don't walk in fear, no matter what's going on. Don't walk in fear and trust God, because fear alone, if you look into anything about fear, fear causes the body to be sick. Let me go in. I don't want to make this video too long, but I remember a couple months back, I think last year, the Lord had said to my husband and I individually to take care of our bodies. And this was right before COVID hit. And yeah, we exercise, we eat right, we do our green juice, we do our fruits and vegetables, we have our snacks here and there. I can do better with snacking, but we do take care of our body. I take organic, you know, vitamins and stuff like that and all that. But any what else do I want to say? So much I want to say. There's so much going on. There's so much that God is revealing if you're paying attention. But if you're just caught up in this life, take no thought for your life, and the Lord will make a way for you. But if you're caught up in this life, it's very difficult for you to hear the voice of the Lord, because you have so many other voices in your head, the news, you know, and all this stuff in your head, so you're not able to hear God and hear what He's saying and see what He's saying. It's so much information that God's given us, so much truth. I don't even know when we'd get to share all that truth. Some of it is like, I mean, most of it, all of it, honestly, apart from us, you know, seeking God and trying to walk in His will and do what He says, a lot of it just literally dropped in my lap. So I can't boast, I can't brag, I can't be prideful, but everything that I have and everything that I know has been given to me. You know what I'm saying? God's given it to my husband and I. I'm in the car with the baby here, holding the kids and stuff. He's over there with the kids at the park. But yeah, guys, the message is still the same. Repentance for non-believers and believers alike. I'm not sure if you guys are aware of what's going on, because they don't really cover this stuff on the news per se, but there's so much going on, guys. Rat plagues in Australia. China is basically broken down at this point, you know, with all the storms and the rain and the locust plagues. And, you know, a lot of Europe is washing away, you know. There's a book that I read said, go on to Asia. But that's for another time. But a lot of things are broken down, a lot of things are falling apart, and there's gonna come a time, there is coming a time, this is the time where you're gonna have to make a decision on whether you're gonna choose life or you're gonna choose death. And God already gave the answer in the word. You know, He said, you know, to choose life, You know, I set before you life and death. And he gave you the answer. You didn't have to study for that one. He said, choose life. Sorry, I got to pick up the baby. Forgive me. Let me put the phone down a minute. But, you know, we have to choose life. But, guys, there's so much I want to share. Hopefully, I get the opportunity to share it. And I just discipline myself to share it. But at the end of the day, choose life. So that's all I gotta say. The message is still the same, guys. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Some people think they got all day, but tomorrow is not promised. Today is the day of salvation. If you hear his voice, harden not your heart. And like I said, guys, for those of you who pray for me and my family. I pray for you and your family. God puts sometimes different ones on my heart, or heart to pray for, but now is not the time. Now is not the time to be doing whatever you want to do. It's not. Now is the time to seek God in your decisions, seek God in who's around you, because there's so much deception, so much chaos going on right now in the whole entire world. This is a time of consummation. God's judgment is on the land. And whether you know it or not, it is on the land, and it's unfolding very quickly, actually. So much going on with this virus too, and I'm not even gonna get into that right now, but the message is still the same. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Whether you are a believer or a non-believer, it's time to repent. Excuse me, I'm out real quick. But sorry about that. Yeah, it's time to repent. Because a lot of you believers, you're not following God. You're not reading your word. You're not telling people about the Lord. You're not doing what God said for you to do. And you need to repent. And you need to stop. And you need to do what God tell you to do. I'm so dry. But, and non-believers, the time is closing up. The times of the Gentiles is coming to an end. And you ain't gonna have no time to repent. But now you need to build yourself up in your most holy faith and trust God, you know. So, yeah, guys, that's what I have to say today. 7 minutes long. Yeah. Love you guys. God loves you more. Yeah, keep the faith.